Congratulations, Mr. Brandon Phillips.
Your boy's going through it right now, man. If y'all look, I only got 22 miles left, you know. My gas is damn near empty. I don't get paid till Thursday. And the main reason I went in my truck is for this right here. $2. Your boy's going through the struggle, but gotta remain positive. You know, this is only temporary. That's how I look at it. And we just gonna keep pushing, man. See the title, man. The big news I've been hinting about for the past two videos, it's here, man. And I really want to talk about it and give y'all a little background on, you know, me, the journey just to get back to this point, and, you know, a little bit of my life story, man. But before I get into the video, it's day three. You feel me? It's day three. We still going strong, man. I know 3 days is not a lot to y'all, but we still going strong, man. Consistency is key. Shout out to everyone that watched the last video, that liked. We ain't get no comments, but
oh, lame, man. Nigga, fuck you talking about.
But yeah, man, just shout out to the people that are really supporting me for real. I appreciate y'all. As y'all see from the title, this video is basically gonna be me explaining to y'all how I went from being homeless, like really living out the car for 2 years, playing professional basketball overseas. The reason I'm making this video in the first place is because I just want to inspire, you feel me? There could be someone that was in my exact same situation that might come across this video on their For You page or home screen, whatever it's called. They might come across this video and it might give them some inspiration, man. Now, a quick disclaimer, I won't be talking too much about how I was homeless and what I went through being homeless, because this is just a quick little video, man, to inspire. It's not a sob story, whatever. I'm also not gonna be throwing anyone under the bus or speaking bad on anyone, any of that stuff, man. This video is solely just for the purpose of inspiring whoever is watching it, you feel me? After the JBA, your boy was homeless. I was living out my car for 2 years. No parents, no nothing, you feel me? And basketball really wasn't like a priority for me anymore. I kind of like fallen out of love with the game, because like I would still go hoop here and there, but I just had like real life problems that just took away from my ability to focus on basketball. So I would say for like 3 years after the JBA, I wasn't really like, I would touch a basketball like 1 or 2 times a week. And that was just at runs. Also, quick disclaimer, nobody, like, while I was homeless, like 2 years, none of my friends, nobody I hooped with, like nobody knew. So if anyone's in the comments, like, why didn't you like reach out for help this and the third? I didn't tell anyone, and I made sure it never looked like I was homeless. Like, kept my parents up, all that good stuff, man. But just to give y'all a timeline, like I played in the JBA in the end of 2018, right? I was 19 years old, and from age 19 to 22, I was homeless. You feel me? Or almost 22. It was like a couple months before my birthday, my 22nd birthday. But yeah, your boy woke up on his 21st birthday, like in the whip type. Nobody, like no family, no nothing around, just waking up in the car. And that just hits you a little different, man. But yeah, like I was saying, basketball was just not really a priority for me at the time. I really just had to get myself together. It all started with, you know, getting a job and then finding a room to stay. The first room I ever rented was a room off of Craigslist. It was like $600 a month, you feel me? And it was a tiny room. I was so proud of myself for getting that room. I did it all by myself, you feel me? And from there, I was able to get myself, you you know, just mentally back into a state where I could pursue basketball and pursue YouTube and other stuff, other things of that nature, you feel me? So yeah, man, we got our first room at age 22. And quickly after that, I was only in that room for like, I would say 4 months, 4 or 5 months. And then I ended up getting my first apartment. Yes, first apartment. I moved in with two roommates, but I was there for a whole year. I just recently moved. I got a move-in vlog dropping for y'all soon, but yeah, just recently moved, but I was in my own apartment for a whole year after that. And I was beyond proud of myself for making that happen. But anyways, I know y'all want to know, how did I get this opportunity? How, B Philly, how are you going overseas? When I haven't played in 3 years, no game footage on me, 3 years. I'm gonna let y'all know, especially with COVID and everything that happened, I know a lot of hoopers don't have game footage. I know a lot of y'all are always looking for pro opportunities. So I'm gonna let y'all know how I did it, you feel me, personally. So I don't know if y'all know, but as far as like overseas like looks and like overseas tryouts, the spring and the summertime are when the scouting and the signing periods are just going crazy as far as like overseas basketball. So towards the end of me being homeless, I was actually going to a lot of overseas basketball combines, man. Shout out to OBC, that's one of the big companies, one of the big combines out here in the United States that I was going to. I went to the LA combine about twice, you feel me? And OBC ended up branching out into another company. The founder is Antonio DePina, and he basically has just been, he took OBC, his overseas basketball combine, and it's just exploded, man. So basically, he founded this league called the Praia League, and it was in Praia, Cape Verde, South Africa. I hope that's how you pronounce it. But yeah, man, basically, I had tried out for that. If y'all have seen my last video, the combine video, that was a tryout for that league, right? And long story short, I played well. I played very solid in the two games that I was given. And when draft night came, I just wasn't picked up. I wasn't drafted. And so I was kind of bummed, you feel me? Because I've just been looking for like that pro look, like that pro opportunity. This is just some advice for like hoopers. If you ever don't make a tryout or don't make a team, don't leave with like a bad attitude. Like, make sure you shake all the coaches' hands. Make sure you're still cheering on your fellow combine players, all that good stuff. Just radiating positive energy, because you never know who's watching you. I'm not gonna lie, like, I have a lot of friends that play pro. I've played against ex-NBA players. I have plenty of mentors, this and the third. Scouts will really come to your games and they'll have someone just watching like your demeanor on the bench. Like, how do you act when you get subbed out the game? How do you act when you feel like you may have got a foul call that you shouldn't have, or something's not going your way in the game, or coach runs a play that's not for you? There's a scout assigned to watch all of that, your on-court and off-the-court behavior while you're at the game. Are you cheering on your teammates? Are you high-fiving other players as they check out? Or are you at the end of the bench, you know, mad, just moping around? So attitude, y'all wouldn't believe it, man, but attitude plays a big part in whether a team will sign you or not. You feel me? But yeah, man, I didn't get picked up, but I was still positive. Like, I never had anything bad to say about the league, this, then, and third. And I kind of just thought like, oh, that was it. I was over with. Let's look for another route. You feel me? Another opportunity. But little did I know, the scouts and the GMs at the prior league, they were impressed with my play. They remembered me from the tryout, right? So there's this league called the CVBL, which is the Cabo Verde Basketball League. It's in Cabo Verde, West Africa. It's founded by the same founder, Antonio DePina, right? And one of his contacts basically reached out to me and said, hey, look, we remember you from the tryout last year, the prior league trial last year, and we want to invite you to a training camp. We want you to sign a training camp deal. So yeah, man, I didn't have to try out for this league. You feel me? They remembered me from a tryout that happened last year. And yeah, man, your boy is going to Africa. You feel me? Your boy is going to Africa. I've signed a training camp deal. And I really, like, when I tell you I've been waiting on this for so long. Like, truly, I've been waiting and manifesting this for so long. I do leave for Africa the 18th of May. The training camp is not until the 22nd of May, I believe. But I do leave for Africa the 18th of May. You feel me? And I'm excited. You feel me? Your boy is ready. I've been working out. Like, my game is solid. Like, everything is just ready to go. I'm ready to go, like, right now. But I still got a little month and a half, a little under a month and a half. And yeah, man, we're going to keep grinding, you feel me? Keep working and just staying ready for that opportunity. But Africa vlogs coming soon. Africa basketball videos coming soon, man. I've never been. The last time I was out the country was when I was like 7 or 8 years old. If y'all don't know, your boy's a dual citizen. Right, so yes, I'm a U.S. citizen, but I'm also a British citizen. You feel me? It's my passport. I gotta get it renewed. My UK passport. My U.S. passport, we're good to go. But yeah, I've gotta get my UK passport renewed. And for me, like, I know the title of my last video was From JBA to the League. That's gonna be a little series, I call this, but my goal is really not even the league. I just want to be able to make a full-time income off basketball, just hoop for a living. That's really the dream, man, and just be able to support myself and take care of myself solely off basketball and social media, because those are my two favorite things to do, man. Basketball and social media, those are my two, like, true passions. And I feel like it took me a while to actually start pursuing those passions, just because of outside noise and people saying I can't do it, this, that, and the third. Like, kind of got in my head a little bit for the longest, but we here now, you feel me? Everything is ascending and everything is looking good, man. Everything is definitely on the right track. But yeah, man, even when I was homeless, like, I've always had the utmost belief in myself. I'm a true believer of speak it, believe it, receive it. Means if you put it out into the universe and you work for it, you will receive it. You feel me? I've always been a believer in that. And I truly feel like this is the start of, like, my real pro basketball career. You feel me? I'm not gonna let this opportunity blow me by or go to waste. You feel me? So I truly believe that this is the start of my pro career, man. And yeah, man, I'm glad I could take you on this journey with me. 5 years from now, y'all gonna look back and be like, man, I was watching B Philly, you feel me, before he did any of this stuff that I'm about to do, you feel me? So shout out to y'all for rocking with me since day one. This is literally the day one, or day three, technically. But yeah, man, I appreciate y'all rocking with me, you feel me? Basically, long story short, your boy's going pro. We're going to Africa, you feel me? I know I said earlier I got the dual citizenship. A goal of mine, a dream of mine, is to really play in the British Basketball League. You know, in the UK, doesn't matter what team it's for, I just really want to play in that league. You know, and go back to my roots, man. If y'all don't know, like, half of my family is from the UK and still lives in the UK. So it'd be dope to see them. Be dope to go back to my roots, man. If y'all know, I actually lived in the UK, London specifically, for a short period of time. It's about to be a journey, and I hope y'all stick with me, man. It's B Philly, though. I'm out. Peace. I dropped low, then I came up. I went down, then I got.